Hi everyone, this is Angelica with Handmade by Angelica. I have a really fun technique to show you today. It's the technique that I used to color my frog on Joanna's Blog Hop frog card. I told you guys that I'd be doing a tutorial showing you how to blend this way with your Copic markers. What we're going to need for today's tutorial is you're going to need at least two contrasting Copic markers in the same color family. So I've chosen the red violets, and I have RV21 and RV95. And then you're also going to need to use your colorless blender. And then for the stamp that I'm using also a brown. I'm using E34, which is like a creamy beige. But you could use whatever you want depending on whatever stamp you're going to be using. I'm also using this Unity stamp. It's really adorable. I love it. It's a dress form. I'll have to find the exact item number and name of the stamp for you guys later because I couldn't find it when I was just looking really quickly right now. I'm going to be using Antique Linen Distress Ink by Tim Holtz and Memento Rich Cocoa Ink for the stamp itself. Memento is what you want to use when you're using Copic markers so that you don't get any bleeding with the inks together. This technique is really easy to do. If you haven't been using Copics for a while, this is a really great one to try. It's not necessarily what you're going to be using all the time, but for like a wash of color, it's a really nice way to get that effect. So I hope you guys enjoy it. This is my first video, so if there's any bumps along the way, just bear with me. I'm sure they'll get better as I go on. One of my New Year's resolutions was to get more involved with my blog and do a little bit more tutorials and show you guys how I do things and also learn from you guys. So I hope you enjoy it. Thanks for watching. All right, you guys, let's get started. What I'm going to do first is take my Ink Essentials blending tool and my Distress Ink, and I'm just going to start sponging on this Antique Linen color. And I'm using the Ink Essentials Nonstick Craft Mat. These work wonderful for sponging, painting, anything that would require heat, like heat embossing or a glue gun, because they virtually repel every single substance. The only thing that I would not recommend using these for is, well, of course, with anything that can puncture them, but also with Copic markers. Once I'm done with this, I'm going to remove this mat because what will happen is if I leave this on here and I start coloring with my Copic markers, the nonstick craft mat will repel those markers when they start to seep through the cardstock and it will end up showing up on my image, and I don't want that. It's a regular piece of scratch white cardstock. You want to make sure that it's clean because, like I said, if any ink goes through it, it will pick it up. And now I'm just inking up my stamp. I'm using the Memento Rich Cocoa Ink. And I'm going to apply even pressure. And don't worry if it's not completely straight or anything. We're going to trim this down eventually after we're done. And I'm going to start laying my color in. So what I'm going to start with first is my lightest color, which is RV21, and I'm going to start applying the color where I want it the most, and that's going to be the areas that will be the darkest.
Well, I was sitting, waiting, wishing you believed in superstitions, then maybe you'd see the signs. Lord knows that this world is cruel, and I ain't the Lord, no, I'm just a fool. And I'm loving somebody, don't make them love you. Must I always be waiting, waiting on you? Must I always be playing, playing your fool?
Using the colorless blender for right now is to just basically pull these colors together. Typically you would not use a colorless blender to do this. You would use an even lighter pink, but since we are using the Distress Ink as our highlight, what we're doing is erasing where the color actually is, where the pink and that mauvey purple are, and we're letting that distress color show through. So whether you use, you know, like a blue Distress Ink, or if you use a light pink, that would be really pretty. Whatever color you use is the one that will pop through when you start using your colorless blender to erase some of that ink. And now I'm just going to go in with the brown that I chose, which is E34. It's actually like a creamy beige. And I'm just going to touch in the sash where I want the color to be. And if you can see, I just kind of went in towards the sides, because whenever you look at something with the light shining right on it, you know these parts are going to be lighter. So I'm just going to shade in here on the bottom. And I think up on here on the top of her neck too. I say her, she's not even a person, right? She's a dress form. Anyways, okay. So since I want that creamy linen color to show through, the antique linen color, this E34 just blends so perfectly with that color. I'm just going to use the E34 in her sash because it's going to look almost like it's gradually flowing into the distress ink. So here we have our image. It's all ready to go, all ready to be trimmed down and put on a card. So I'll be back and show you guys the rest of the card that I made with this image. I sing your songs, I dance your dance, I gave your friends all a chance.